is an author. She's a published author, and she's written this book called Self-Publishing 101. Have you thought about writing a book? Do you know how to get it published? Or have you thought about self-publishing? I think this is a grand book.
And really what they do is they're trying to recruit him because they know he has gifts. They've been watching him for a while, and they really just want to kind of use him as part of their team to hunt down evil and defend the weak. And they say that if he does join them, then they will be more than happy to help him look for Stephanie. So there's a lot of, does he trust them? Who is this group? Is this the truth? But at the end of the day,
The essence of the First Amendment. If you think about the five different rights that the First Amendment protects, one of them is the freedom of the press. A separate one is the right to speak. When you think about the tools that we today have available to us on the internet, the right to speak and the right to press converge because all of us essentially are entitled to the same rights that journalists are with respect to disseminating information. And
first step from there might be that you go on LinkedIn and make sure you have an account. If you already have an account, it'll tell you if you had 100% profile completion. If you're not, make sure you had 100% profile completion because you get 40 times more job opportunities. And then not everyone listening to this is looking for a job, but you also get 40 times more business opportunities. So if you already have a job or run your own business, you should be on there at 100% profile completion.
Poker players, it's just there's not that much difference between like a regular person and a pro. It's just the fact that obviously the skill level, but it's a lot to do with, like you said, bankroll management. So if you have a certain unlimited funds, you could really just move up in the poker industry really easily because there is a luck variant to the skill component as well.
Right. And I guess that alone is probably one of the reasons why it's so popular.
I have 15 documented concussions, but
You
there's
probably
a
have
chance
more than that, yeah.
I have more,
Yeah.
but I can't document it or prove it.
No.
So that's the scary part about
Well, that
concussions
should
when you
put
have
you on
something new about it.
disability as it is, but oh
You would
well.
think.
That's another. Let's
Stephanie and I met on a platform called Stage 32. She's been filmmaking for many years now. This is her 10th documentary film, and we wanted to get her on the show to find out a little bit more about her and her projects, and also how she is using technology to work on her projects and how it's helped shape what she's doing now compared to what she's done years ago. So
This epidemic. How did this cause this epidemic? And so there was dimension, intellectual dimension to my film. And it took your attention to watch this film. I had a friend say, "Oh, I got my pillow and my popcorn, and I was going to watch your film on TV when it came out." And I couldn't eat and I couldn't lay down.
So is the internet a right or a privilege from a legal standpoint?
Well, that's an age-old question. And when I say an age-old question, a question that's been around maybe the last 20 years since the internet's been easily accessible. So why don't I answer that question for everyone right now? Why don't I solve this mystery in this particular Google Hangout? And let's get to the bottom of this. All I can tell you is in California, driving an automobile is a privilege. It's not a right. You have to pass tests. You have to operate a vehicle in a safe fashion. And once you show that you're able to do that, we let you get behind the wheel and drive. And it's like that in most states. I would like to think that the internet is a right. That would be great. That's just me. It's probably not the lawyer in me, but I think it's a great tool that allows people from around the world to connect. It's allowed the three of us to become friends. And it's an awesome tool. But then again, if, for example, when I'm accessing the internet on my Verizon phone,